All right, maybe it wasn't such a good idea to let this thing dry. It certainly has dried up. How the f*** am I gonna cut this thing open? I don't think this thing is gonna cut, this razor. I think I'm gonna be going through a couple of blades, but we're gonna try. I guess there was that benefit of when it was still slightly damp, of cutting it then. This, when you do get a cast removed, a doctor does have a rotary saw, and I may end up having to use my Dremel or something like that with a cutting bit on it to do this, but we're gonna give it a shot and see how it goes. So I figured the easiest way to do this is to draw a line just straight up the side. It cuts. All right, not as bad as I thought it was going to be. But I'm going to get a different razor. My linoleum cutting blade. Hopefully this will do a little bit better. It certainly gives you more leverage. Plaster crap might be the best thing. Seems to just want to pop right off the form. Pretty cool. And the other half. This is what I was talking about though, when I was saying I was tempted like not to even do the back of it, that this would almost be sufficient as it is for the effigy to go on top of the sarcophagus. There's also something to be said for it to sit together too. So what I'll do now is I'll reattach everything. Hot glue it together first to hold it in place and then run the plaster over it. I'm sure I'll get my fingers stuck in the hot glue again. Right into it. Oh, f***ing fuck. All right. And that's held together now. Now I can put the plaster over the top of it. I went to a medical supply store today to try and get the plaster gauze bandages, and unfortunately they didn't have any. They had fiberglass ones, they said, which was like $80 a box, and I was like, nah, that's okay. They gave me these, basically the same as the ones that I had picked up at Walmart yesterday. It's 3 inches by 4+ yards. However, these are non-sterile. They were half the price, actually less than half the price. So it was 12 rolls for $5, for $4.50. It was 12 rolls for $4.50. That was 5 rolls for $4.50. So getting even better with the deals. I should just give up vlogging because I can't figure out how to work a f***ing camera. Holy cow, my memory card was full. So I emptied it, went to go reformat it, and completely forgot. Now to address that issue about attaching these arms. It's not going to be as much of a problem as I was initially anticipating. What I decided to do was like to mount it like this, cut it off at the elbow, bend the arm in as I want it to go, and then just use great stuff foam. Spray it in there, fill up that area, and then shave it down to the shape that I want. So I think that'll be an easily workable solution. And we'll start working on the legs. Pieces keep getting bigger and bigger. So just like I did with the torso though, I'm gonna use the clear plastic wrap, because that seemed to work well. And do my shrink wrap. Unfortunately, I have to stop here, stop a little early. Have to tend to some fires on the home front. So I'll finish this up tomorrow, start on the second leg, and then put another coat maybe on this one too. But our torso, I think, looks good. I think our arms, we can work around getting it onto the body in the form that we want. This leg actually does look like just a straight leg. I have to see what the other leg looks like. Yeah, hopefully it's just the same. And worst comes to worst, we just do some adjustments on it too. All right, if you like what you see, give the video a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel if you don't already do so. And let me know if you got maybe any other ideas on joining the two, or what you think of my idea of cutting at the elbow, filling it with foam, and shaping the foam to fit. Okay, thanks for watching.